Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Dark Souls 2. In our last stream, we did a little bit of dark diving, took care of two of the chasms, tried the third, but that dual hammer turtle bastard is annoying, so I'm gonna come back to him a little bit later, and then we came to do something else that is both really cool and really annoying at the same time, the Sunken City. We made a good chunk of progress in. We just have to go down there to do the dragons, or I could go this way to the bullshit. And because I'm feeling slightly masochistic, I think I'm gonna go remind myself of why this is the bullshit. Because, yeah, the DLC in this game really does exemplify the best and worst parts of, like, Dark Souls 2's level design. Because on the one hand, you have something like this, which is set up in a very challenging manner, but looks really cool and is a really, like, big, well-designed, multi-layered level. And then you have this shit, which is narrow, ganky as fuck, tons of those fucking things, and ends in, like, the things that just, like, move around and petrify you that you can't kill, and ends with one of the worst fucking bosses ever. I will light that on my second way through, because no doubt I'm gonna die at least once. Oh dear. Maybe even right away. Yep. Oh shit. That was bad. But yes, this part is the bullshit. Like, now, I will still try to farm out items, because, like, even, like, the area with the spike floor, I was like, there's not much worth getting out of here. And then I cleared out the area and was like, oh, keys, petrified dragon bone, there's actually a lot of good stuff here. Come on. Ow. And everything about this place is nasty once you go down those holes. And yeah, the boss of this area in particular as well is just like three NPC reskins. Like I think it's actually the trio that you fight in the Drangleic Castle Dark Chasm. Because it's a Havel Knight, a Ricard, and I'm pretty sure the other one is, like, a magic user of sorts. Oh, God. No. No, no, no. Oh, dear. I don't even want to do this. I don't even know what that was. I don't care. It was something. God, it's coming back. I'm gonna bother fighting things in there. We're just gonna speed run to the boss. Try to get my blood stain back. Pick up whatever items I find in here. Because this is like a purely optional area. There's no key items or crazy armor or anything. Light that next time. Right, and there are worms too. I will take it. Oh dear. Mm. Yeah, it's an Alva, an Archer, and a Havel. And the best way to do this fight really is to just keep moving. From what I remember. And not run right into a corner like I just did. But, oh my god. At least I kind of remembered the easiest way through. Dead end. Also dead end. Fuck! Oh no. No. I should have just gone for the chest. Holy crap. Aldia's Keep is slowly starting to sound like a lot of fun right now. Or going down the Shulva Tower and fighting those dragon things. But now I'm curious about that chest. Oh. Yep. The absolute, like, laziest, worst level design of any Souls area are these optional DLC areas. Like, I've experienced this one. I've experienced the Blue Smelter Demon one. I never bothered to go too far into Ilium Lois, so I personally have not had to deal with reindeer fuckland, but that's gonna change in this playthrough. I will deal with whatever reindeer fuckland has to throw at me. I just want the chest, man. Petrified something. All that way for a petrified something. think the path is that way. Yeah, like the items down there aren't even worth it. Is just to be able to say, I killed those three assholes, mainly. And I don't even know if I want to do that right now. I just wanted to remind myself of why this place is literally the worst. The worst! Oh shit. Oh no, no. Literally the fucking worst. Fuck this. Yeah, just fuck this. Fuck this for now. I got my petrified something out of the goddamn chest. It's just a dumbass gank squad boss that doesn't even give you a fucking soul down there. You know, let's go down. And, like, the biggest shame of it all, too, is, like, aside from that, this whole area, challenging as it is really well done. And, like, that's the main thing about this part of the DLC, is that, yes, it's very challenging. It's spec'd for endgame, and it's one of the hardest things you're gonna do in the entire game, is these three DLCs. But, like, completely fair. Like, I actually really appreciate the way these DLCs are set up. I appreciate that I can outrun all of these flaily fuckers. And I super appreciate that they will not follow me in here. They drop petrified dragon bone. Oh my god. There's so many of them. Thank you. Getting somewhere. Heyo, DK. Thank you for tuning in. You've got me killing weird slug dragon things. There are so many of these fucking things. And the trick is fighting them one at a time. And not getting hit by their damn AoEs when they fire at you from afar. Come on. Come here, little guy. I believe in you. I believe in you. Come here. Ha ha! They do four stomps. And they drop petrified dragon bone too, so I can level up boss weapons with their stuff. And they're actually not that bad to fight up close. You just don't want to be fighting more than one of them. I have my nice little kill box right here. God, that is just a scary sight. It's out of range. That shot has an AoE, so you gotta be careful. Come on. I'm right here. Oh, you only did two stomps. Oh! I'll take it. I will take that. Jesus. Okay. I think there's one left, and then I'm in the clear. Got a little bit more freedom now that a bunch of them are dead. And I think that is the last one. Three human effigies. Oh, that makes up for the dark diving I did in the last stream. Is that a bonfire? It is. I'm not sitting at it yet, but I would light that. Really does look like it's the last one. Soul of Great Hero. Yeah, this is so much better than what I started the stream with. That cave can go fuck itself. You heard me. Like that, did you? Two, three, four. Punish. Shit. Last one had to put up a bit of a fight, I guess. Dried root. It's apparently some kind of potent healing item. And that is where the drop-off is. What we got here? Oh, I can put that dragon eye that I found in here. Now I can re-enter the temple through the main entrance. Gotcha. See, like, this place, great level design. The optional part of this place can eat a fat dick. Choke to death on it for all I care. Let's explore the rest of down there, then. Another human effigy. And this probably leads me back up. I'll do this before I go back down, but I am gonna go back down first. We'll go into the temple in a bit. Like I thought. Right back to the start. Down we go. room. So what's here? Oh. The Drakeblood Greatsword. That sounds like it could be fun. It actually weighs less than the Claymore. A dex scaling. It is a dex weapon. It also does lightning damage and magic damage. Wielded by the Drakeblood Knights, led by the Honorable Sir York, the insignia chiseled upon the hilt symbolizes dragon's blood. To the Drakeblood Knights, fresh dragon blood was sacrosanct. They believed that by obtaining it, they could achieve a true understanding of life, transcending their own banal existence. Well, I'm glad I found that. I will be up in the decks a little bit more, and like, the more I do that, I could probably pump that thing. If I put some minerals into it, that might be good too. Lightning damage is always fun, and lightning damage is actually quite deadly to most of the bosses in this game. Right. Just in case. Send that elevator back up, since the bonfire mat is up there. And let's do this. This is where I'm glad that I have the cat's ring equipped, because this is a drop. Nothing but drops from here, pretty much. So we are going down, down, down to Dragon Sanctum Town, following the singing. Yep, there's the fog wall. There's the boss down there. Hi! A Drakeblood Knight. Fat rolls. You don't want to do that. I will teach you how to two-hand, buddy. You are NPC, not real human. Yes, run away. So is there anything of note in here? I can hear a lizard somewhere. I think I get it. Yeah. Oh. go down there, it looks like. I do really appreciate the creepy singing in this area, too. Pointless, therefore don't you dare. Jump, Lord Ad. I don't know if I can make that jump. Go the other way. Hexing urns. Oh! Mine's better. I can just take a safe way down. Oh, not completely. Don't think I can light that one. They are fun to fight. Oh, hi! Oh, I see the hole. Oh, that wasn't a hole. This one's, that is just straight death. Oof. Well, we got the Drake blood set, but yeah, somebody raided all the chests before I could get here. So sad. It really is. Getting closer to the bottom, too. I feel like I missed an area up there. Here. No. Nothing at all. I know there's a bonfire that I missed somewhere on the way down, so if I die, we'll try finding it, because it'll be much less of a trek. This is a neat boss.
You do not deserve anything, Maya.
Ooh. That's an AoE. Summoning. Oh, she summoned Velstat! Great! And she caused an explosion. Yep, she can summon the boss that was guarding Vendrick. Or she'll summon skeletons. RNG. Gotta love it. Okay. Yeah, I actually make it down there pretty easily without fighting all the Drake Knights, but at the same time, oh, she's always inviting more people to the party, because, like, you saw it, like, her moveset on its own. Nothing really to write home about. So, without help, like, I could have taken her pretty easily. But of course, like, the one that she decides to summon is fucking Velstat. All right. Welcome to the fall. Thankfully, you can pretty much do this without getting into any fights. Oh, fuck! My mistake! I meant to hit the jump button, but that works too. Vine bomb. Hello. Twinkling Titanite, that's good. Well, this was, like, a good platform to drop to, but didn't yield a bonfire. That's kind of what I was hoping for. Oh, well. Three hits! Okay. Yeah, I can understand it too. There are some bosses you can backstab, technically. Nah, I'm not up for a duel. I got bigger things to worry about right now. Hmm. such as a squalid queen. Hey, I actually have more than I started dark diving with before. All right. Let's take this again. Since I do have the cat ring and can try some slightly riskier jumps, I'm going to see if I can find that bonfire on the way down each time. Until either I find it and then have a shorter trek to get to Elena, or she kills me. Try jumping. Sure. Don't know if I'll make that one. Sure. I may have fucked myself jumping to here. Well, that one gave up. All right. YOLO jump. Holy shit, I made it. Damn. Okay. Yeah, let's see. How does she like a lightning blade? Shove dinner. She's actually slightly okay with it. You, Skelly. To you too, buddy. Does a decent amount of extra damage to her. still have no idea where that bonfire halfway down there is, but... Good God. It would make the run back tour a little bit more standable, because this is a damn long run back. But it gives you plenty of time to reflect on your mistakes. Going for her too much and not caring enough about the skellies. Because, like, she's fine to deal with. Like, with a little bit better stamina management, I would have no problem with her. Like, I already have no problem with her when she doesn't have her adds. It's when she summons her adds that is just like, oh. Like there's an item in there. Or it could just be lighting. Could just be lighting. Ooh. Ah ha! You don't need to be following me, buddy. Ah shit! Well, so much for all the souls that I had accumulated that were sitting in the boss room. That's what this entire run has been. It's like, oh, I've got like halfway to a level. Nope, no you don't. Whatever. It's just lighting. There's a stairway that way. That makes me wonder. No, that's not a stairway. What the hell, we're experimenting. Oh, it is a stairway. And there's a dude there. But I'm on the wrong side of this. Oh, right. You ran down there to get to where the dragons were. So this is... Yeah, that's a different part of the level entirely, and I'm just dead now. So, bye! Experimenting! Fun! Thank you. think I'm gonna take a peek around those other areas again, where the Drake Blood Knights are. See if I can find that bonfire. Really, I don't need to, but just anything to make it that much quicker to get back to Milena. Even though it shouldn't take me too many more tries to kill her. It's just, at this point, it's mainly getting to her that takes forever. They're tough bastards. They really are. Yeah, I was already on that platform. Didn't have anything. Been over there, been down there. Maybe there's like an illusory wall around one of these things. The bonfire? I don't know. I don't even know. All wishful thinking on my part. Where did he come from? You know what? Screw it. I'm just gonna fucking speed through this place. God. That was just brutal. Mm-hmm. I will take that shortcut, as it means I don't have to deal with those assholes. Feels like there should be a bonfire, like, just down here, but oh well. I'm gonna try something else, just because I can. Hey. Why not? If she's summoning help. Steelheart Ellie, an NPC phantom. Sure, if she's summoning help, I'll summon some. Have a good night, DK. Thank you, Steelheart Ellie, for serving as a great distraction. You do absolutely no damage. I was actually doing way more damage with the lightning resin. Oh God. Oh, right, because I have, like, almost full health because I died. I was like, how the fuck did I get back up to full health? Am I still alive? I thought I just died. Just like, no, I'm dead. It's just, I have almost full health. God damn gravity. again, Aldia's Keep is starting to sound mighty nice right now. But I at least want to kill Elena. Oh. And T-Man. Oh. No T-Man. Let's do this. She chose to go with Velstat. It's good. She can keep Velstat distracted. Oh my. Nearly had Velstat down. And it's interesting that she decided to, like, come in and close range with him instead of, like, hanging back and firing hexes like she did when she summons in the skeletons. Far too heavy. I'm gonna need to pump more into vid if I want to use a bigger sword than this. Might be worth running back to Majula, cracking some souls and seeing what happens when I level up the Drakeblood sword. Great sword, because that is a really good sword. It's a fun one to use. I'll summon in the help one more time. What the fuck, man? Nope. Fuck. It just not enough time to heal there. Like, I thought I had the range, but nope, skeleton just came running right in. I need to be doing more damage. That's all that is to it. So, I think we'll come back here later. Huge waste of time, it almost feels like, but whatever. It was fun. Except for the fucking... Cave of the Dead place, that place can fuck itself. Something I wanted to get though. Now that I have the King's Ring.
Human, do not light. What do you require, human? You have met the King, have you? Life is never easy, never fair. Even more so on this path you've chosen. May you find your peace one day. Take these with you. You may need them as proof of your visit here. This place is what death is. Tell me what you desire. Show me reverence, and I will lend you my hand. I am a finito. This top countless souls rest here. Somewhere.
Yeah, okay. Now he's repeating himself. Thanks for your stuff. Out of here now. Okay, I'm going to do exactly what I said I was going to do. Level up that Drake blood sword a little bit. Katana of Great Warden Ogdain. Has a crystal clear blade and a strong attack that slices through enemy's shields. This katana was originally wielded by the one who gave us the first death, and still exists imperfectly between planes. Shield piercing for strong attack, that's cool. Where is that dragon? Drake blood sword. There it is. It takes petrified dragon bone? Wow. Why not? is already...
I'll be around.
That's already... So that is doing more overall damage. Not a big fan of that. It wields much more like a straight sword. Interesting. Well, we'll try it out. Gonna eventually go back to the Black Gulch and do the final Dark Gate as well, but I actually want to level a bit first. That's the way to Ilium Lois and Drangleic Castle. This is the way. So bad. There it is. Where are the... There they are. More petrified dragon bone. That's good. Fortunately, I also now know exactly where I can farm petrified dragon bone. And there's a bonfire right next to the spot. Y'alls almost didn't seem hostile. They petrify you, huh? Bonfire. I wonder, now that I've done this, does Nishandra say anything different?
Brave undead, seek the throne. Follow the symbol of the monarch, and do what must be done.
She just wants me to go right to it, I guess. Well, everybody must get stoned at some point. Well, on that note, I think this is a good time for me to take a small break. Everybody must get stoned, as they say. But we are going to come back. When we come back, we are actually going to continue on with the main game instead of the DLC and hit up Aldia's Peak. And after that, who knows? We are going to eventually get back to the DLC bosses and the DLC areas because Sunken Crown is almost done. Like, after Lana, you just walk through a door, basically, and you fight Sin. And that is probably the most fun of the three dragon fights in this game, in my opinion. But, well, I have other stuff to do here first, and hopefully that'll get me some better levels, because I'm feeling like something, like, I'm feeling I could pump this guy a bit more before doing some of the endgame content for this. But, yeah. This was fun. Frustrating, but fun nonetheless. And, until next time, y'all have a good night. Stay safe. See you in the next stream. Be excellent to each other.